Yeah, when I get tired of killing somebody, you know, I'm writing, I go to my romance. Oh, I need some love and
right.
fun, you know, or my sci-fi geeky stuff, you know.
Well, and even what Rebecca had said, I mean, this is so much more. Like you had said, I am not going to be a narrator. You know, I can't even tell you how long it takes. To get, you know, 20 minutes of actual good finished recording.
Oh, yes, I do.
It's unbelievable how long that takes, you know? And for me, when I first started, I was being way too perfectionist. Yeah, I just, I went way overboard. And I'm like, okay, I bet nobody else does this. I've got to stop. So I had to back off.
Yeah, but you're pretty good at what I've listened to a lot of you.
Yeah.
Actually, to a lot of all of you.
Yeah.
But you're really good at what I call laying back and getting into the pocket.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I do record for long periods at a time. I mean, I do that. I'm in the groove and I just keep
That's
on
what I'm
going.
Talking about. And I can tell. And
yeah.
It's not sluggish by any means.
Right.
You actually, I can feel like when the intensity starts driving up, your yeah. voice, and I almost can visualize you going, and now.
Exactly.
Getting into it, you know,
yeah.
I can almost feel your heart rate increase yeah. with some of that impact.
Yeah. So well, and that's, like I said, we're acting. We're acting. You just can't see us.
Yeah. yeah. And I swear, Rebecca, oh man. I have laughed at Jessica's, your portrayal of her, and I should. That's a compliment. Or have I sent you the 18-minute short film?
Yes, I have not watched it yet, and I didn't want to.
Okay.
Because I didn't want to get all...
But when it's all over, you really got to watch it.
I will.
And it's funny as hell, Jessica, in there.
Yeah.
And that's actually my daughter, Jamie, again.
Oh, no. I want to make sure that I don't offend anybody in my portrayals.
You're not offending anybody in portrayals. So let's sum this up. This has been a fabulous conversation roundtable. And I want to thank from the bottom of my heart from authors for narrators, because I don't view it as my book. And I don't think y'all have ever heard me go, oh, it's my book. You can't do that when you're reading it. You know,
we've heard it from other authors.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we need to talk about this then, because yeah. you actually hit on it a little bit, Rebecca. And yes, I do have in my mind, because I have a lot of these in screenplays and short films already produced mm-hmm. that I think I know what the character is about, but I released that.
Yeah, absolutely. A whole different program.
Yeah. But I released that to say, no, they're going to bring this to life the way they do it. And I think of an author. And like I said, you hit on it just a little bit. I think the author is so steadfast that they're not willing to allow that narrator the freedom. Mm-hmm. I think we won't have as quality of a product.
Yeah.
We have to let the narrator breathe and do it.
I have one more tip for a narrator that I forgot to mention. Especially when you're just starting, there is a very... there's a trend in audiobook narration, voice, vocal styles that are out there for the young. And when you first start, and I did too, I spent a lot of time trying to emulate the best-selling narrators. And so many of them sound so familiar, because there is a certain lilt to the voice. There's a certain rhythm that they all kind of have, almost like a radio broadcaster. You have just a sound. Don't get stuck trying to have the sound. Because I didn't start picking up my big paying books until I was like, screw it. This is how I feel it should be read. And it's very different delivery than the standard sound. So don't worry about trying to be any sound. Just be you so that you can be authentic.
Yeah, That's advice I had gotten from a voiceover artist who was very well established. And he told me, don't, you know, one of the worst things you can ever do is try to sound like somebody else.
I tried it. Doesn't work.
You tried it.
I did. First year.
Never tried it. Don't care to. Don't want to.
I did.
Not me. I'm going to stick to writing, okay?
Yeah. I sounded so different from anybody else that was supposedly successful. I thought, obviously I'm not a fit, so I have to figure out how to fit. And then once I decided I didn't care if I fit, it was just fun. Getting hired.
I hope they're really listening to you with this, Rebecca, with over 200 books, audiobooks under your belt. It's not as if you don't know what you're doing.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and I will say this, when I was auditioning for all of my books, I never looked at a person's credentials until after I scored them.
Oh, thank goodness.
I did. And I thought I made it perfectly clear that I didn't care if you had 200 books or no books. After the voice.
That's wonderful.
You know, and I honestly did not look at anybody's credentials until after they were literally in my top 10. And it was like, and I'm glad I did that. Because I found some diamonds in the rough.
Excellent.
Like you, Chris.
Thank you.
I found some true diamonds.
Yay.
And I consider that with all of y'all that way. So thank you from the bottom of my heart as the author for bringing your voice and life to my characters.
I love to be your voice.
Now that your voice is going out, right?
Yes. I understand. Well, we thank you for the opportunity.
We're going to make this happen. I feel like I have assembled the five best out there as far as narrators go. And I think you already know this. I love to market. And most authors don't. They hate it.
Yes, they do.
I actually think it's thrilling. I'm going to be marketing the bejesus out of all this. And I just hope we all just rise to the top together as a team.
Wonderful.
Very good. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Poor Chris. Hang in there, kiddo.
Hang in, baby.
This is what I've been like for several days.
Yeah, but what do you take for that, people? Rebecca, Timothy, we all get like that. And you're having to narrate.
I use, it's a thing called Biotene. It's a mouthwash that's you.
Uh-huh.
The other one is a mouth spray. It's called Professional Singer's Mouth Spray. And it thins the mucus. And it actually has a slight muscle relaxant in it.
Does it, it prevent prescription?
No, you get it at a health food store. I'll put it on my website and send you the link.
On my website, because I want to know about that too.
Yeah, it'll take a little bit of the spasm.
I do a lot of interviews. Not me typically interviewing like I am right now. People interviewing me. I do a lot of interviews because of my book. And sometimes I get like that and I'm just like, oh my God, I need something.
The Biotene is great for sticky teeth, and the spray is good for the spasms and the thinning the mucus. So,
all right. Nice. Well, we're going to break this down and call it a wonderful first round table. And I hope there's others, whether it's one-on-one with you, where we're going to read some of the books and highlight exactly what you do, or as a group or two of us or whatever. Y'all have some very valuable information that you can share with other people, whether it's authors or narrators. And to me, they're a team. They shouldn't be considered, oh, I'm the author, I'm better than you. Oh, I'm the narrator. I'm like, no, people, you're in this together. It is a team framework, period.
Yeah. Nice.
And so I'm glad you all are part of my team.
Glad to be on your team.
All right.
Thank
so
you.
We're checking out. And everyone say goodbye real quick. Say bye.
Bye, Mr. Burke. Bye, everybody.
Bye, y'all. Thank y'all so much.